Good evening, everybody. Good evening, Electric Sheep Minion. How art thou? I hope you are well. Evening, Pat the Beard, Betty Gemini, hello, Mark, and other lovely people. Lovely for you all to be on board so early. We'll start the quiz promptly at 9 o'clock, as promised. I will also sing a song, as promised, but I'm starting to think that was a really stupid idea. I listened back to the last show on YouTube, and the guitar... can't really hear the guitar, so I'll have to work on that for next week. Maybe pre-record the song on WhatsApp video or something, I don't know. Anyway, welcome everybody. Anybody that is watching or joining us on Facebook, there isn't anybody yet, so there's no point telling you that. Move over to Twitch. But anyway, anybody that's in, I'm just going to... Type George into the chat, folks, because I have the raffle up and going. Let me just put a little note in. Type. Type George to join tonight's free draw. Let me just make sure that it is working. Is it working? It looks to be working. Yes, indeed. Minion Jesse's already in. Betty Gemini, Little Sheep Minion. Gordy, good evening. Aberdeen calling. NL, SRB, Mike has just joined. Pat the Beard, okay, it is working. Okay, well, that's a bit of a relief. Okie dokie. Yes, indeed. Type George into the chat. NL, so you have a way to subscribe with Prime. Do you have a way to subscribe with Prime? Quite possibly, but I'm not really sure what you mean. Anyway, we can get to that. Okie dokie. So we will be going live at the top of the hour with the quiz. Bit of a different show tonight, folks. I got a email sent to me by one of the people that come to the quizzes, used to go to the quiz in the Sherlock Holmes, Johnny B. He sent me a history round. So we have a guest history round tonight. I've sort of played with it and made it multiple guests and some true or false, because it was a bit out there. Yeah, but I mean, I love the fact that he's come on and done this. Nice to see. There's a blast from the past. Mike Bax, only here for the beer. Nice that you've joined us tonight. Great stuff all together. NL is saying, have a look at it. Anyone with Amazon Prime can subscribe to a Twitch channel for free and it should pay you. What is it going to pay me? Amazon's. No, okay, I will look into that. Thank you very much indeed. yes, folks, great to be here tonight. I'll give it another couple of minutes, then I'll do my quick wee song. And, and we'll get started. Her Indoors, of course, has decided that she is not coming in while I'm singing. But that's her choice. Anyway, I know she checks it on YouTube.
Have you finished yet?
Not yet, not yet, not yet. All right, okay. Let me just get set up yet. Honestly, she's got the friggin' ears of an elephant. She's also got the memory of an elephant, but that's another thing. Okay. Pat the Beard, great to see you, my friend. Okay, let's give this one a go. Evening, Ardo. This week's song. Any requests or any songs you'd like me to give it a go, send me an email via irishquestionmark@gmail.com. And I'm just seeing that was one of Norma's favorite songs. Well, Norma, that was just for you. Absolutely beautiful. Thank you very much indeed. Norma's got timed out by Streamlabs because she's sending funny emojis. Anyway, applause. Thank you very much. But Ardo keeps asking for Bohemian Rhapsody, but whenever he comes to visit me and does the show sitting next to me, we can sing it together. There we go. There's a solution. So anybody that is watching the show on YouTube or on Facebook, you can jump over onto twitch.tv/IrishQuestionMark, and you can then chat in the chat box, the chat room. You can also join the free draw for one of the Irish Question Mark mystery prizes. Jan the Man, top of the evening to you. Yes, folks, don't forget that you need to type George into the chat to join tonight's free draw. The draw is up and going at the moment. So if you'd like to get involved, just type George into the chat. Betty Gemini, you're already in the, you don't have to chat, you don't have to type it again. Yes, indeed, Lucky Sheep Minion, best behavior indeed, because we have Jan the Man, our official FIFA referee, here tonight with us. Let me see, yes, in who is, yes, 17 people in the draw so far. Betty Gemini, Dutch referee, you have also just joined them. Liz the Legend. Okie dokie. If you're watching it on YouTube, you can also, on the Irish Question Mark YouTube channel, you can also jump across to twitch.tv/IrishQuestionMark And that'll get you entrance into the live chat room and to do what these other people are doing and join tonight's raffle. Yes, folks, a little plug that if you miss your Irish pub quizzes and you would like to hire me, Irish Question Mark, to come and do an online show, I can tailor make it to your companies with your logos, or we can do it with families and friends in a Zoom room with a little bit of music in the background. Everything is possible. Just drop me an email at irishquestionmark@gmail.com and I'll get back to you straight away. So if you would like to discuss the possibility of doing a show for your company or for your friends and family, then contact me directly via irishquestionmark@gmail.com. Okay, let me just try and get a little bit of music in the background for myself before Heron Doors comes in and starts. Good evening. There she is. Talk of the devil. I'm telling you what, she's psychic. No, not psycho, Norma, but I like the way you're thinking. Okay, let me... Our friend Tom, by the way, just phoned me as I was in the middle of singing the second line of the song, Her Indoors. I think he might have seen it going on live on Facebook and thought he'd try and wind me up. But I had the phone on silent this time because I learned my lesson. Okay, so folks, anybody that has not done it yet, type George into the chat. You won't get a message to say that you have entered the draw, but I will check and let you know if you've all entered. So if you're in the Twitch room watching it tonight, just simply type George and you can enter tonight's draw. I haven't got a clue how loud this is going to be. Yes, folks, also, we will be doing the Spin the Wheel game tonight again. I have it up and going, and I can assure you that it did work. It did work earlier on today, and if it doesn't work, it's all Her Indoors' fault, because we need someone to blame. Good evening, Robert. Nice to see you. Captain Beer joining us tonight from the... Only here for the beer team. Okay, folks, look at the time. I need to get started here indoors. Folks, if you want to see or be in contact with me, you can check out our Irish Question Mark Facebook page, the YouTube channel, simply by doing a search of YouTube. Also, I'm on Instagram, and if you'd like to send any photographs, contact me irishquestionmark@gmail.com and email me any photos. It would be lovely. Holy Moses, Pete, formerly of Dublin, is on Carrick on Shannon. I think he's made a modern day pirate and has hijacked a boat. Good evening to our resident secret agent, that is aka Jody's dad, for anyone that isn't aware. We have our own security here tonight. Yes, type George. Electrosheet Minion saying, I'm going to keep my fingers crossed for the bonus round. I'm not quick enough to type the answers anyway. Well, the answers are quite out there. That's all I've got to say. So you can, you're better off just having a guess. Betty Gemini said, there is security. Does that mean you have to behave? Well, you've got to try and behave. And lovely to see Anne Thompson now following us. And that's Anne that used to work in O'Shea's in Rotterdam, I do believe. Nice that you have joined us. Okay. Minion Jesse said, all your webcams are belong to us. I think he's hit the wine already this morning, earlier on this afternoon. So let's get started, folks. Evening, Pete. And yes, it is Anne. Pretty Anne with a beautiful smile. Used to work in O'Shea's. Beautiful for you to join us tonight. So send me any photographs of you or your team or your family members playing along with the quiz show tonight. And I'll put it into next week's show. Yes, indeed. Thank you very much, Sophie and Senna. It is time to start the show. So all you need is a pen and a piece of paper. You need to pour a beverage off your own choice and write down the answers on a pen and piece of paper. Please don't put the answers into the chat because other people are playing along. Yes, do as Peter has done and type George into the chat and you can enter tonight's draw. Okay, so our first question tonight, our first round is a multiple guess round. In 1768, Captain James Cook set out to explore which ocean? So you have four choices. Is it A, Pacific Ocean, B, Atlantic Ocean, C, Indian Ocean, or D, the Arctic Ocean? It is one of them four choices. I see in the chat that Gordy in Aberdeen was saying, Pete, we're thinking of taking a boat holiday on the Carrick and Shannon. Would you recommend it? Just let me know, Gordy, when you're heading to Carrick and Shannon, and I'll let a few of my friends know that you're visiting. Moving swiftly along. Question number two. Yeah, they'll look after. Question number two. Which of the following is not an international organization? A, FIFA, B, NATO, C, ASEAN, or D, the FBI? Which of the following is not an international organization? A, FIFA, B, NATO, C, ASEAN, or D, the FBI? Okay, your next one in our first multiple guess round. These are tricky questions for everybody. What is the speed of sound in kilometers per hour? Do you think it is 120 kilometers an hour? 1,200 kilometers an hour, 2,200 kilometers an hour, or 3,200 kilometers per hour? I can rest assured that it is most definitely one of them. Number four, what do we call a newly hatched butterfly? A, a moth, B, a butter, C, a caterpillar, or D, a chrysalis? Harry Doors, you looking for that? Now, folks, don't forget, you will know when the bonus question is going to come up. It's going to come up and surprise you all. But you'll see how it works. Bang! And that's why I said it, because it is bonus question time. For anyone that doesn't know what the bonus question is, I have increased the number of people that can enter the bonus quiz to six winners. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask a pretty random question. I want you to type, and only for these bonus questions, type the answer that you think it is into the chat. The chat room, and whoever is the closest answer, her and Doors will be checking this. we will announce who it is, and I'll give you the actual answer when I think most of you have got your answers in. Jody's dad is already attempting with yes, no, maybe, maybe. No, well, actually, it is a number answer. So here is the first one. Get your think. What was your time? Her indoors. Fingers on the tight makes no sense. Meat sticks on your what?
On the ticks.
Meat sticks on your ticks.
On the ticks.
On the ticks. She's not well, folks. Okay, here we go, folks. Listen carefully. It's not 37. It's not 17. It's not 27. It's a lot more than that. The question is, including the antenna on top, how many meters tall is the Eiffel Tower? Ardo is not over 9,000 meters tall. That's why you're the comedian. Minion Jesse, 14.3 billion. That is also wrong. Indoor Kite says 184. Liz says 320. 325, Robert. Pete, 300. Minion Jesse, 315. Norma, Jesus, has Fred never took you to Paris? 700 meters. Gordy says 200. Damar, 560. Anne, 136, Space Tracker 360, NL 897. You've obviously not been to Paris. If 325 is correct, I was at least quicker than Robert. All right, no problem. I'll check that. I'll check it. Okay, now people are starting to look it up, ladies and gentlemen, because the answers are all getting close by. Let me see. Where did Jan the Man come in? Was Jan the Man out first? Okay, Ardo had already put in his score. Ardo came in with 324, but I think that was after he looked it up. The correct answer is, in fact, 324, but the first name that we're going to get put on the... Robert says he wants a VAR. Her endorses the VAR, mate. There's no arguing with her. So, the first person that guessed it, thank you for your honesty, Ardo. Ardo looked it up. He was just taking the piss. I can say that, but you can't. You get timed out. It's a family show. Please refrain from using foul language. So the two women in my life, her indoors and Liz the Legend, has said that Jan the Man is the closest. So her indoors winner number one for the Wheel of Fortune is Jan the Man.
Woo!
Congratulations. Well done. Ardo wants to know, Ardo our FNC wants to know why taking the piss is bad language. Because the computer says it is. Mike Bax has just given us a little clever piece of information. Because the Eiffel Tower swells during the summer, it does in fact go to 325. But I was asking him at the winter time. Alrighty. It's Jan the Man. Which football team does Jordan Henderson play for? Is it A, Liverpool, B, Manchester City, C, Tottenham Hotspur, or D, Chelsea? Her indoors is feeling better again, by the way. Yes, indeed. She's the whistle, she's in action again. So, question number five in our first round, multiple guess round. Which team do you think Jordan Henderson plays for? Her indoors, are you checking whether he still plays for these teams?
No, I know who he plays for.
You know who he plays for. Alrighty. Question number six. Which of the following songs was the top-selling hit in 2019? If you think it was Someone You Loved, type in A, Someone You Loved, B, Old Town Road, C, I Don't Care, or D, Bad Guy. That is your four choices. Her indoors.
What?
How's the coffee? Okay, great. Thank you. Gordy says, thanks very much, Pete. You're the only decent Irishman on the show. Can I get you the Carrick and Shannon man, I tell you.
English.
Question number seven. Don't be calling Gordy English. He's Scottish. Number seven. In total, how many novels were written by the Bronte sisters? A, 4, B, 5, C, 6, or D, 7? So, one of them is the correct answer. Gordy says, get the almond-flavored coffee out. Gordy, behave yourself, Gordy. Question number eight. We often use sodium bicarbonate in the kitchen, and I also use it when I'm making the famous Irish soda foils, folks, which you could win if you get on that spinning wheel. What is the other name for it? Sodium bicarbonate. What is the other name? Is it vinegar, A, B, sugar, C, salt, or D, baking soda? So, sodium bicarbonate is, what's the other name? Pete and Rachel saying, thank you very much, by the way, for the soda farls. Although, rumor has it that Pete didn't get all of his batch of soda farls back. They got raided in the pub, and Rachel only got a token one or two. That's what I heard. I mean, not wanting to stir it up with the soon-to-be newlyweds. Number nine, what is the rarest type of blood in the human body? A, it's AB negative. B, it's O positive. C, it's B negative. Or D, A positive. Yeah, Sharon, Irish Sharon took some of the sort of files from him in the pub. Oh, you got four home. Okay, you were lucky. So, folks, that is number nine. Now, before I go for question number 10, I'd like to introduce you somebody, ladies and gentlemen. I got a video this morning, or a video during the week, anonymously, from someone who claimed to be the Dingbat Man. Alrighty, folks, what can I tell you? We are being stalked. The Dingbat Man sent me the video anonymously, so I've got to put it in the show from now on. So I want you to solve this Dingbat. You say what you see to reveal a well-known six-word term or phrase. The Dingbat questions and the anagram questions are worth 5 points tonight, ladies and gentlemen. So they are the ones that you really need to take a little picture with your telephone and try and get the correct answer. Okay, let's move on to round number two. But before we do that, I got to remind you that if you are watching this on Facebook or on YouTube, swap over to twitch.tv if you want to be included in tonight's raffle. And type George into the chat if you have not done that already. The virtual tip jar is open. Thank you very much indeed for anyone that sent a donation so far. I'm just going to put the links into the chat. And I'll thank you very much indeed. Okay, so let's move swiftly along. Moving swiftly along. Round two tonight. Double points for round two. These are funny and rude questions that were asked on a quiz show called The Chase, which is hosted by Bradley. What's his surname, Herndors? Bradley is the host, and he has problems holding it together when he's got some strange questions. Now, folks, you will have choices, three choices to choose from. A lot of multiple choice in tonight's quiz show, more than normal. Gordy says, we know what a cockchafer is. Well, then you might get one right. Okay, here we go. In what sport does Fanny Chemler compete for Germany? Is it swimming, show jumping, or skiing? In what sport does Fanny Chemler compete for Germany? Now, on the little pictures, you'll see sometimes different answers lit up. That is just randomly, so don't think that they are all the correct answers. So, number one, double points round. In what sport does Fanny Chemler compete for Germany? Swimming, show jumping, or skiing? You will only see these once, so make your choice and write down the answer straight away. Thank you, family J. Ter Harmsel, for your donation to the virtual tip jar. Cheers. Number two. The giant cock that was placed as the fourth plinth in Trafalgar Square in 2013 is what colour? Red, white, or blue? The giant cock that was placed as the fourth plinth in Trafalgar Square in 2013 is what colour? Red, white, or blue? Question number three in our double points round. According to the saying, what must you not let under the tent? A camel's hump, a camel's nose, or a camel's toe? According to the saying, what must you not let under the tent? Camel's hump, camel's nose, or camel's toe? Her indoors is looking rather confused. Pardon me? Question four, a sport question. Dump, floater, and wipe are techniques used in what team sport? Badminton, volleyball, or water polo? Dump, floater, and wipe are techniques used in what team sport? Badminton, volleyball, or water polo? Thanks for that, Pete. Pete says he doesn't know, but you'll find the first two in his bathroom after a feed of pints of Guinness. Bit too much detail. Number five, pussy and crack are varieties of which type of tree? Willow, cherry, or redwood? Pussy and crack are types of which tree? Willow, cherry, or redwood? Question number six. Which of these fruits has hairy driplets? Coconut, gooseberry, or raspberry? Which of these fruits have hairy driplets? Is it the coconut, the gooseberry, or raspberries? Not a lot of chatting going on in the chat room at the moment. People are obviously concentrating. Not the usual style of questions. Question number seven. Now, this is one that Gordy and Susie should get right. A cockchafer is a type of what creature? A bird, a baboon, or a beetle? A cockchafer is a type of what creature? Bird, baboon, or a beetle? Oh my, Pete. Good evening, Baronessa Burnham. I was concerned and worried. I thought our resident secret agent had taken a hit out on you when I didn't see you in the chat earlier, but I'm glad that you're still here. Question number eight in our double points round. Which of these is a real tit? The Adriatic, the Caspian, or the Baltic? The Adriatic, the Caspian, or the Baltic? Question number 9. Cockshot and beaver are terms used in what game? Is it backgammon, kerplunk, or twister? Cockshot and beaver are terms used in what game? Backgammon, kerplunk, or twister? No, it's not a trick question, Minion Jesse. It's only used in one. And question number 10. Holy Moses, it's anagram time. Happy birthday, Frank. Handbag Tit Men is an anagram of which new addition to our online show? Three word answer, folks. This is worth 5 points, the anagram. So mix the letters up and get a three word answer. Handbag Tit Men is an anagram of which new addition to our online show? Thank you very much, Aaron Doors. Lovely cup of coffee. Yeah, baby. Okay, folks. So make sure that you type George into the chat, and you too could be on this little gallery of former winners from the Irish Question Mark Cups, the face masks, and you could possibly, if you have typed George into the chat, be next on our Mystery Prize Winners Club. Now, all of these people have received a very special Irish Question Mark Mystery Prize, and only these people know what the prize is. Baroness of Burnham, is Uncle Tony with us tonight? I just wanted to check that he received something I sent him. If you would like to be in the draw to be a member of the Mystery Prize Club, then simply type George in the chat, just like Grab88 did, and you can enter tonight's free raffle. Let me have a little look and to make sure that the raffle is still working so Herring Doors is not panicking. Well spotted, Pete. You already split us up in the mask pictures and we're not even married yet. Yes, Pat the Beard, you are entered into the draw. Indeed. Grab 88. I'm having a little look now. Yes, Grab88 is in there, indeed. Okay, let's get back to the show. Round 3 is Geography Trivia Round. Geography Trivia Round. Question number 1. Which country's territory is geographically closest to the North Pole? That was easy for you to say. Holy Moses, that coffee's hot. Doesn't taste of almond, but it's just burnt my throat. Which country's territory is geographically closest to the North Pole? I love the way Herring Doors looks up into the sky like she's searching her random encyclopedia in her head to get the correct answer and then looks down, broken. Oh, no, you didn't. Question number two. On which Italian island is Palermo? On which Italian island is Palermo? Question number three. Which is the largest desert on Earth? Because you would say like a baked Alaska. Don't shake your head. I know what you like. Which is the largest desert with sand on Earth? Just keeping it nice for her indoors, folks. I'm also going to ignore Gordy. And as I ignore him, it's bonus question time, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to have to get some sort of a jingle organized for bonus question time. Maybe get you to sing one.
No.
Yeah.
I'll make
one. How in the mother of how are you gonna make one? Okay. So she's gonna steal one off the interweb. Bonus question time, folks. What I need you to do is I need you to listen very carefully. Meat sticks on the ticks is not gonna be the tagline for this. It is. Meat sticks on the fingers on the type. Yeah, that was the other one. That was the one you come up with. It's no wonder you don't work in television. Fingers on the type. Okay, where was I before I was rudely interrupted? Yes, I was going to ask the bonus question. Hey, Gordy's wrote Steven Gerrard as the answer. No, it's not which who's the manager of the current Premier winners. No, thank you. Choppers on the blocks. No, I like that one. Radiant Raluca likes the meat sticks. I bet you she does. Right, moving swiftly along. Question. Question number two for you to get your name on the bonus spin the wheel. Okay, now we want a number as the answer. Her indoors is going to say when the when you think it's, you know. No, you don't. No, it's not an easy one. Okay, here are the questions. Ardo's put two in. No, there's a few more than that. To get your name on the bonus question time, the bonus spin the wheel, I want you to tell me how many people survived the sinking of the Titanic. So whoever's close enough before the correct answer comes in two or three times in a row. Betty Gemini, I think she was watching the movie. It's not 12. As soon as I see the correct answer, I'll know someone searched it, you know. Norma's doing a countdown. 700, 800. Answer's still coming in. Answer's still coming in. Naughty Norma is at it again. Okay, folks. The correct answer is 492 passengers, 214 crew. So the closest answer before they started getting silly and Liz looked it up and put 705. Even her interweb's wrong. Do we include the per hooker that wasn't allowed in the door even though there was enough space? Maybe that's the extra one that Liz was including. Mm-hmm. So, her indoors, you decide who do you Minion think it Jesse. Was?
He said 705 and it's 706.
Minion Jesse said 705 way earlier on as a guess.
Yeah.
Okay, then. That was just before Norma put 800. Absolutely. Minion Jesse is winner number two on our spin the wheel. Don't worry, folks. There are six places on the spin the wheel. You can get the choice of having one of the mystery prizes. Or if you live locally, I'm making some soda farls tomorrow, folks. The Irish question mark soda farls. The most sought after, handmade and loved bread farls, basically, on the European mainland. Number four. Question number four. Which Turkish city has the name of a cartoon character? Which Turkish city has the name of a cartoon character? Question number five. 2 points up for grabs, two answers required. Brazil shares a border with every South American country except two. For 1 point each, I want you to name the two. Baronessa Burnham saying, Uncle Tony got his prize, thank you. Did he get his prize that I sent him yesterday? I emailed him something yesterday, that's what I mean. Because I know he got his mystery prize. But I sent him a Just Eat voucher so he could order pizza to have pizza tonight. Because I thought, well, I don't think his house is big enough for two of the Irish question mark mystery prizes. Question number six. What do the Japanese people call their own country? Thank you, Mom. Question number seven. Fascinating rock formations exist the world over. I'd like you to identify the one in the picture. Question number eight. What is the name of the desert area in Mexico? What is the name of the desert area in Mexico? Question number nine. Speaking of the equator, how many countries sit along it? Is it 9, 11, 13, or 15? Speaking of the equator, how many countries sit along it? 9, 11, 13, or 15? And question number 10. Which country once was called Rhodesia? Which country was once called Rhodesia? Okay, folks, that is halftime, our first three rounds. If you have not done it already, type George into the chat, and that'll get you entered into tonight's draw. The virtual tip jar is open. Thank you very much for anyone that has sent a donation so far. I've just put the little link into the chat. I greatly appreciate any donations that have come in so far. Thank you very much, folks. Okay. Let's move along and give you the answers to the first three rounds. You know where to find me on Facebook, or you can watch a rerun of this show on YouTube or on Instagram. And if you are watching it live now on YouTube, hello, but you're not, because I can see there's no one. Here are the answers to the first three rounds. 1 point for each correct answer, unless I tell you differently. Number one, in 1768, Captain James Cook set out to explore which ocean? For 1 point, the correct answer is A, the Pacific Ocean. Question number two. Which of the following is not an international organization? The correct answer is D, the FBI. Number three. What is the speed of sound? The correct answer, 1,200 kilometers per hour. Number four, what do we call a newly hatched butterfly? The correct answer is C, a caterpillar. Five, which football club does Jordan Henderson play for her indoors? The correct answer is A, Liverpool. Question number six. The song that was the top-selling hit in 2019 was Someone You Loved. Would you like to give us a few bars of it, her indoors?
Yeah.
Little Adele classic?
I
bet you do. Number seven. In total, how many novels were written by the Bronte sisters? The correct answer is D, seven. Number eight, we use sodium bicarbonate in the kitchen. The other name is baking soda, D, baking soda. Thank you very much, Jesse and Micah, for your donation to the virtual tip jar. Question number nine, the rarest type of blood in the human body is A, AB negative. And number 10. It's the Dingbat question. Introducing the Dingbat Man. The correct answer for 5 points. The ball is in your court. Yeah, that's great, huh? Thank you very much, Dingbat Man, whoever you are. 5 points if you guessed the ball is in your court. Also like to thank Peter and Rachel for your donation to the virtual tip jar. Cheers, thank you. Here we go, double points up for grabs, 2 points for each correct guess. for the questions from the chase. Number one, in what sport does Fanny Chimler compete for Germany? Swimming, show jumping, or skiing? The correct answer for 2 points, skiing. Question number two. The giant cock that was placed as the fourth plinth in Trafalgar Square in 2013 is what colour? The correct answer for 2 points is blue. Of course it is. Number three. According to the saying, what must you not let under the tent? A camel's hump, a camel's nose, or a camel's toe? The correct answer is a camel's nose. Because if you let its nose under, it's more than likely going to come on in totally, as opposed to a camel's toe. And it's a family show, so keep your thoughts clean. Holy Moses, it's another bonus time, ladies and gentlemen. It even caught me by surprise. Get ready. Bonus time. Type your answers in the chat. Tents and skirts are two different things. Meat sticks on the ticks. I'm going to have to sit down and think of a decent one. Here is the question, folks. Type your answer in the chat. The question is, remember, anyone that is already on the wheel, you can't go on the wheel a second time. Who are our two winners? Jan the Man and Jesse Minion. Okay, the question is, to get you on the spin the wheel, fingers on the type. Thanks, Jan. Yes, of course, you can still play. Sticks on the clicks. I like that, Betty. How many stars are on the Brazilian flag? How many stars are on the Brazilian flag? Herondores, I need you to check how many stars are on the Brazilian flag, because I'm feeling nervous looking at all these scores. Minion Rachel is spot on at 27 stars on the Brazilian flag. Norma was so close. Naughty Norma was so close at 29, but not close enough. Pete had 28. That was a good guess. He's obviously had another mouthful of Guinness on his boat on Carrick and Shannon. Baroness of Burnham thought I was being clever and wrote zero. Congratulations, Rachel. Your name is now on the spin the wheel. Pete in Carrick and Shannon, thank you very much for your donation to the virtual tip jar. Moving swiftly along, dump, floater, and wipe are techniques used in what team sport? The correct answer is volleyball for 2 points. Number five, pussy and crack are types of which tree? The correct answer is willow trees for 2 points. Number six, which of these fruits have hairy driplets? Coconut, gooseberry, or raspberry? The correct answer is a raspberry. That's what them hairy things are called on the outside of a raspberry. Number seven, probably, quite possibly, the only one that Gordy in Aberdeen got right. A cockchafer is a type of what creature? Is it a bird, a baboon, or a beetle? The correct answer is, it's a beetle for 2 points. Thank you very much, Mike, for your donation to the virtual tip jar. Cheers. Number 8, which of these is a real tit? The correct answer is Caspian. You can't call Gordy a real tit. He might take offense by it. Number 9. Cockshot and beaver are terms used in what game? Backgammon, kerplunk, or twister? The correct answer is backgammon. Whatever way you are playing, the games, Pete or Gordon, keep it to backgammon. Gordy's not happy. You calling him a tit? Yes, you did. Ladies and gentlemen, look who it is, your friend and mine, Liz the Legend, Handbag Titman. Did anyone get this one? It's an anagram of which new addition to our online show? The Dingbat Man! Give yourself 5 points if you worked that one out. Okay, just before I give you the questions and answers to round 3, is Arto, our FNC, our Finnish comedian, is he still with us? And at half time, when I come back and start the second half of the show, will he be doing a few one-liners for us? Please let me know, Arto, in case you've fallen asleep. So, round 3. Here are your answers. Back to 1 point for each correct answer. Which country's territory is geographically closest to the North Pole? It is Canada for 1 point. Number 2. On which Italian island is Palermo for 1 point? It is Sicily. Number 3. Which is the largest desert on Earth? It is the Sahara. Thank you very much, Radiant Verluca, for your kind donation to the virtual tip jar. Number 4. Which Turkish city has the name of a cartoon character? It is Batman. Number 5. Brazil shares a border with every South American country except 2. 1 point for each correct answer. The answers are Chile and Ecuador. So 2 points up for grabs for these two answers. Number 6, what do Japanese people call their own country? Obviously, I did not want home as the answer. The answer is Nippon. Number 7. Fascinating rock formations exist the world over. Identify this one. I was so tempted to say, would you like a clue? But then I couldn't have said it's got nothing to do with Ireland. I have taken her indoors here and was very tempted to push her into the ocean, but she survived. Beautiful place called the Giant's Causeway. Pete saying, does it make me homesick? Pete, I've been homesick for since COVID-19 started. But her indoors, I've took her indoors that many times to Ireland, and she's been welcomed every time. God only knows how. She's even homesick for Ireland. Gordy says the Scottish version is better. You mean that little one that's about the tenth the size of the Giant's Causeway? On the other side of the water? No. Minion Jesse says, is it the giant pub crawl? No. What is the name of the desert area in Mexico? The answer is Sonora. It is not El Deserto, Pat the Beard. Naughty Norma, thank you for your donation to the virtual tip jar. You were so close to getting some soda farls, Norma. But you know where I live, and you know my phone number. So a little quick call might just get you some when I'm making some tomorrow. Number 9, speaking of the equator, how many countries sit along it? The correct answer is 13. And number 10. Which country once was called Rhodesia? Rhodesia. The answer is Zimbabwe. Do you know the capital of Zimbabwe, Herndors?
I tell you, last week it's Harare. Get your act together.
It is Harare. It's the capital of Zimbabwe. Okay, folks. So just before we take a little break, if you want to send any photographs of your team or your family members playing the quiz show, or if you want to share any news with us, you can email me directly at irishquestionmark@gmail.com. Unfortunately, folks, I got an email this week, a little bit of sad news, and I just thought I'd share it with you all. One of the quizzers that used to come to the O'Shea's in Rotterdam, the Fiddler, the White Horse, Gunter, big German Gunter, passed away during the week. So this picture was a lovely picture taken by Junior in the Fiddler at the Christmas show in 2019. He's a member of the Only Here for the Beer team, and that's most of the team are here tonight. Pat the Beard, Liz the Legend, Mike Batts, Captain Beer. And I just wanted to pass on my, my thoughts are with you all. Shocking. Absolutely shocking. Anyway, his suffering's over. Okay, folks, I'm going to take a very short break now. Arto, if Arto is still here, can he leave a chat in a little note in the chat so I can call on him when I come back? Yes, Anne Somerson used to work in O'Shea's in Rotterdam. Yeah, that's right, Big Gunter. Okay, yes indeed, Pete. Also, Ralph from the Sherlocks passed away. Another quizzer. Thank you very much, folks. I'm going to take a very short break. I'll be back with you in about 3 or 4 minutes. Thank you very much. Cheers. Thank you. Alrighty, folks, back. Thank you very much. I just got a fantastic email from the Baroness of Burnham, and we'll definitely include that photograph in next week's show. Absolutely superb. Yes, folks, anybody, if you'd like to get a photograph of your team or yourself playing the quiz show, then just do a selfie in front of the screen, and it would be lovely, just so everyone can get a face to the name. That would be wonderful. Yes, we will be doing the spin the wheel later on at the end of the show, and also we do our free raffle, and you might get to win some prizes, some Irish question mark endorsed materials, as we shall say. We don't have any more cups left, and we don't have any more masks left, but we do have, I'm not going to say it, we do have an absolutely superb, beautifully, much sought after mystery prize, folks. If you have a look at the pictures of the people that have already received it, they were rather surprised. And I'm really glad how it turned out. Uncle Tony needed someone to carry his in to the house. He was extremely happy. So all you need to do is to make sure that you've typed George into the chat, and you've got to be watching the show on twitch.tv/IrishQuestionMark, and then you can chat in the chat, and you can also enter the free draws. The virtual tip jar is open. Thank you very much to people that have been sending in some donations to the tip jar. I've just dropped the links back into the chat. Herman Doris is going to let me know. Some donations have come in there at half time when I was checking my phone. I heard my phone buzzing. Right, let's move on. If you would like, folks, me to come along and do a show for you online, it's dead easy. Just contact me, irishquestionmark@gmail.com. I can do it for your company, or I can do like a fun family one. We can do it on Zoom and have a little music and stuff in the background. Arto, absolutely knackered this week. He's had a busy week. He said, sorry, guys, I need to bow out for tonight. But just before he goes, a little one-liner from Arto, our FNC, our Finnish comedian. I don't trust stairs. They are always up to something. Okay, Ardo, take care. Enjoy the second half of the show tomorrow on YouTube when you're a bit more awake. Thank you very much for popping in tonight, Ardo. I greatly appreciate it. And I'm still waiting for you to come round. Let's get a cup of coffee and catch up in the garden. Boom, shakala. Good night. And Ardo drops the mic. So, folks, you know where to find me on Facebook, YouTube, on Instagram. All you need to do is do a search for Irish Question Mark. Thank you very much, Gordy and Susie up in Aberdeen, for your donation to the virtual tip jar. Round four tonight is a food and drink round. Remember, it is 1 point for each correct answer, and I'll give you the answers at the end of the show. Herman Doris, can you just pass that over to me so I can put the music back on, please? Thank you very much indeed. Okay. Question number one. How many calories does a glass of water contain? How many calories does a glass of water contain? Question number two. Which country is the origin of the Stella beer? Thank you very much, Liz the Legend, for your donation. Which country is the origin of the Stella beer? Question number three. From which country is the famous Emmental cheese? From which country is the famous Emmental cheese found? Which country? Pat the Beard wants to know how large is the glass. Half a liter, Pat. Thanks for clarifying that. Number four. What is the name of the gas that makes bread dough rise? What is the name? Well done, Susie. What is the name of the gas that makes bread dough rise? By the way, folks, Gordy and Susie are up in Aberdeen. I think they have two keyboards connected to the same laptop. Because obviously Gordy has put the bonus question in is how many stones has Susan put on during the lockdown? And Susan has answered not as many as Gordy. Okay, well, I'm not getting involved in that. Question number five will be after the bonus question time. So, get your name on the wheel. The question is, here we go. Sorry. Meat sticks on the ticks. Sticks on the clicks. What was you on the man's? Liz said, my hands are ready. That sounds a little bit saucy. Okay, here we go. The suspense is killing me. Meat sticks. Leave it alone, Raluca. Okay, the question is, flaps on the taps, knees on the keys. All suggestions are more than welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Piggies at the market. No. So here is your question. The question is, in what year was the following person born? In what year was the following person born? And the person that I want you to tell me, what year was he born, is Samuel L. Jackson, the actor. In what year was Samuel L. Jackson born? Her and Doors guessed it. Instantly, she guessed it right. And I was so surprised. Even she was so surprised, it was unreal. No correct guesses yet?
Yes.
Boom! We have a correct guess. Pete in Carrigan-Shannon, 1948 is the correct answer. Minion Micah was just behind him. Norma was just behind her. Oh, Anne in O'Shea said 1968. I don't think she knows who Samuel L. Jackson is. He looks great for his age. Pete says 1941. Whew. Space Dracula, 1967. Was she talking about me, maybe? Even then, she got it wrong. So it is Pete, who is formerly usually based in Dublin, but at the moment he's hijacked a boat and he's down in Carrigan-Shannon. I'd like to thank Pat the Beard for your donation to the virtual tip jar. Thank you very much, Pat. Let's move on. And unfortunately, our friend has just missed this. This is a task question. So, things Arto should know. A wife carrying festival, as you all know, is held annually in Finland. I've asked a question about it before. And it requires a man to negotiate a 253.5-meter course while carrying his wife on the back. The major prize, the first place prize, is the wife's weight in one of the following things: herrings, beer, or reindeer meat. So what do you think the major prize is for the winner of the Wife Carrion Festival? I mean, 253.5 meters. There wouldn't be a chance of me being able to carry her indoors, 253.5 meters. Well, then again, if we were getting our weight in, I suppose it's best to say nothing. So, there we go, folks. That is question number five. Electric Sheep Minion wants to know, do they have the reverse now because of equal opportunities? Pete knew the answer because it's the same year as his mum's birthday. Well, aren't you lucky? Number six. Which French town is known for its mustard? Which French town is known for its mustard? Number seven, what is the name of the pan in which one makes paella?
Paella.
Paella. Thank you very much, Heron Doors, for correcting me, because she's outstanding in both French, Spanish, Dutch, English, and bad language. Who's that? Gary Butt? Is that Gary that we thought was based in Dublin? But he's actually based in Ipswich. We actually thought he was Pete in Dublin, who's now in Carrick and Shannon. But he is, in fact, in Ipswich. And that's Gary, who used to do the quizzes in O'Shea's. Thank you very much, Gary, for your donation to the virtual tip jar. Question number eight. Which vitamin is the only one that you will not find in an egg? I think that's Susie that said I wouldn't carry Gordy the length of myself. Answering Electric Sheep Minion role reversal in the wife carrying. Number nine. What is the largest vegetable? What is the largest vegetable? Aaron Doors, don't be... What did you think? In space or somewhere? Yeah, her indoors. She's planted some seeds today, ladies and gentlemen. This could become a feature of the quiz too, yeah?
Prize-winning
courgette. Yeah. I mean, I don't know why she needs 400 cucumber plants. Question number 10. Oh, no! It's Dig Batman! I can't. This is fantastic. Ding Batman! Alrighty, folks. Thank you very much, Ding Batman, for another rather quick appearance. Solve this, Ding Bat, for 5 points. It reveals a very well known and popular snack. This is so easy that I think even Pete will get this one. Without a shadow of a doubt, her indoors is squinting her eyes and looking confused. But then again, that's how she mostly looks. Why don't you just give the answer right? Yeah. Unbelievable. Okay, folks, our next round is, it's a new feature to the quiz because obviously I ever since I started this show, what show are we doing tonight, her indoors?
Eight.
Are you sure? You want another guess?
58.
You sure?
Yeah.
58. Indeed, you're right. Quiz show number 58. When I started this show, it was all about having a little bit of fun, staying connected with some very special people, and it's become a little monster, and loads of different things got added to it, and I love it. I absolutely love it. So, Tonight is a new round. It is a guest round. So if you would like to send me 10 questions or send me 12 questions and I'll pick the 10 out of the 12, don't make it too hard. Johnny B, who used to come to the Sherlock's quiz shows, sent me some history questions. Now, as you see, folks, they're a little bit tricky, but what I've done is I've made them either multiple guess or true or false. So let's get started. Thank you very much, Johnny B. Let's see how you do, folks. I'll be very, very keen to see what you think of these. First one, number one. I didn't know this, but it's a very interesting fact. The 1928 Olympic Games that were held in Amsterdam. Due to the rapid increase in motor car usage, what now universal traffic sign was first used at this event? So was it the no entry sign? Was it the parking sign, the letter P? Or was it the one-way sign? So for the first time ever in 1928 at the Olympic Games in Amsterdam, a universal traffic sign that is used throughout the world was used first at this event. Do you think it was the no entry sign, the parking sign, or the one-way sign? That is our first question from Johnny B's History Guest Round. Question number two. 3 years to choose from. Name the year these three things happened. The introduction of the Big Mac Quarter Pounder, the birth of Starbucks, and the release of David Bowie's Hunky Dory. What year do you think that was? 1971, 1973, or 1975? Yes, indeed. I will check it before it's put on. Number three, which English town or which English city links the following? The House Martins, Rotterdam, and the Rank organization. Which English town or city links the following? The House Martins, Rotterdam, the Rank organization. Number four. Is this true or is it false? On the eve of Waterloo, 1815, the Duke of Wellington referred to his own troops when saying, "I don't know what effect they will have on the enemy, but by God, they scare the shit out of me." Do you think that's true or do you think it's false? On the eve of Waterloo, 1815, the Duke of Wellington referred to his own troops when saying, "I don't know what effect they will have on the enemy, but by God, they scare the shit out of me." True or false? Question number five. Question number five is Jan the Man. Thank you very much, her indoors. In 1965, Kenneth Wolstenholme described which footballer playing against Benfica. And here's, that's his surname. This boy can really play. He's got another. In 1965, Kenneth Wolstenholme described which footballer playing against Benfica. And here's, this boy can really play. He's got another. No, it's not Pelé, you lunatic. Getting a little bit excited there, Gordy. Number six, Ireland left the British Commonwealth in which year? Was it after the Irish War of Independence, 1922? Was it in 1949 after joining the United Nations? Or was it after 1987 when Johnny Logan won the Eurovision Song for a second time? What's another year, Aaron Doors? Boom! Do you like what I done there? Ireland left the British Commonwealth in which year? One of the following 3 years: 1922, 1949, or 1987. I love the way Electric Sheep Minion just randomly put in the only Dutch footballer that he knows. Yes, folks, this is our guest. This is a guest round from Johnny Rockets. Thank you very much indeed for sending this in. If you'd like to send in a guest round, by all means, email it to irishquestionmark@gmail.com. We'll have a look at it and we'll see how it is. Please don't make it too hard. That's why I sort of had to play around with Johnny. I had to play with Johnny to get it to work better. Question number seven, the Australian national carrier airline is Qantas. It was formed in 1920. What does this acronym stand for? What does the acronym stand for? Norm is saying Republica Air as a whole. Well, unlike you, I don't recognize any borders. Moving swiftly along before Gordy gets involved. Question number seven being repeated. The Australian national carrier airline is Qantas, formed in 1920. What does the acronym stand for? Good old Pat the Beard on the ball, man, honestly. Family Van Trick, thank you for your donation to the virtual tip jar. Thank you. Dublin Pete on holidays in Carrigan Shannon. Do not give Norma any kind of praise. Because she'll just get uncontrollable. At this stage, she's probably on her second bottle of wine. I don't even know whether she's still wearing her pajamas. Do you know what I mean? What can I tell you? It is Friday night, you know? Question number eight. What musical genre was Miles Davis referring to when he said, "I'll play it first and tell you what it is later"? Her indoors has just guessed her second question tonight, folks. She's on a roll. This is round number five out of our six rounds. What musical genre was Miles Davis referring to when he said, "I'll play it first and tell you what it is later"? Question number nine. 2 points up for grabs. Bob Dylan and George Bernard Shaw are the only people that have been awarded which two prodigious prizes? Now, I have asked the previous quiz question about this, but I put it in because I didn't ask you what the prizes were. I actually told you the prizes and asked the names of the two individuals. So it's a sort of question that's been changed. Bob Dylan and George Bernard Shaw are the only two people that have been awarded two very special prizes. Point for each prize, the correct prize that you guess. And our last question in Johnny Rockets' guest history round. Is it true or is it false? All planets in our solar system rotate anti-clockwise. All planets in our solar system rotate anti-clockwise. True or false? Round of applause. Our first guest round. Thank you very much, Johnny. I enjoyed playing with you, Johnny. What can I tell you? Let's keep it personal, my friend. Round six is our last round tonight, and it is a multiple guess round. I don't know why, but it seemed to be a lot of multiple guess rounds tonight. Maybe we'll throw at least one or two multiple guess rounds in the future quizzes, just to make it a little bit easier to guess the answers. Question number one, what does the word piano mean? It either means A, to be played softly, B, to be played quickly, or C, to be played comfortably. That reminds me of me, her indoors. To be played comfortably. Because nowadays I'm built for comfort, not for speed. Question number two. The War of the Roses involved which two houses in England? The War of the Roses involved which two houses in England? Number three, there are up to 250,000 sweat glands in which parts of the body? Your three choices are the tongue, the feet, or the armpits. I just realized the last question I didn't call the answers out. Going back to question number two, the War of the Roses involved which two houses in England? A, Lancaster and York, B, Windsor and Lancaster, or C, York and Windsor? And back to question number three. 250,000 sweat glands are found in the tongue, the feet, or the armpits. Number four. In ancient Rome, what mineral was considered so valuable that the soldiers were partially paid with it? A, sulfur, B, salt, or C, magnesium? In ancient Rome, which mineral was considered so valuable that soldiers were partially paid with it? A, sulfur, B, salt, or C, magnesium? Number five, Jan the Man. Which football club won the UEFA Champions League 2019/2020? Was it A, Liverpool, B, Bayern Munich, or C, Real Madrid? Jan the Man, our official Dutch virtual referee, FIFA endorsed, ladies and gentlemen. We only have the best here on a Friday night. Which football club won the UEFA Champions League 2019/2020? A, Liverpool, B, Bayern Munich, or C, Real Madrid? Question number six, especially for Gordy and Susie up in Aberdeen. Which vegetable was originally used to make jack-o'-lanterns in Scotland and Ireland during Halloween? Peppers, celery, or turnips? Which veggie was originally used to make jack-o'-lanterns in Scotland and Ireland during Halloween? Peppers, celery, or turnips? Question number seven. Where did the boomerang get its name? A, the name of the plant used for making the tool. B, the name of the inventor, Mr. Boomerang. Or C, the name of a native tribe in Australia. Now, folks, it's times like this that it would help if you had an Aussie in your team. but only times they guess, because they can't drink for shit. Where did the boomerang get its name? The name of the plant used for making the tool or weapon is A, B, the name of the inventor, or C, the name of the native tribe in Australia. Number 8. Which of the following objects in your household contains the most germs on average? A, a cell phone, B, a kitchen sponge, or C, a light switch? Which of the following objects in your household contains the most germs? A, a cell phone, B, a kitchen sponge, or C, a light switch? Number 9. What was the original name of the Rubik's Cube when it was invented in Hungary in 1974 by Erno Rubik? Was it A, Magic Cube, B, Rubik's Rectangle, or C, the Color Cube? So A, Magic Cube, B, Rubik's Rectangle, or C, Color Cube? And number 10, he's back, Dingbat Man. Solve this dingbat for a well-known four-word term or phrase for 5 points. Dingbat. Yes, folks, you're dingbats. You simply say what you see. Four-word term or phrase, and this is worth 5 points. If you'd like to be a part of this beautiful bunch of people, our former winners of our Irish Question Mark prizes, then all you got to do is watch the show on twitch.tv/Irish? every Friday night and type George into the chat. That gets you entered automatically into the draw. Our latest prize is a mystery prize, and only these lucky people that are on the screen right now actually know what the mystery prize is. But hey, no one's been disappointed yet, so I think I picked the right thing. All you need to do is follow us on twitch.tv/Irish? Type George in the chat, and you might win a mystery prize. Thank you very much, folks, for anyone that has sent in a donation. The virtual tip jar is open. Thank you. I've just put some links into the chat. Thank you very much, anyone that has sent a donation in so far. And for next week, if you're watching the show on YouTube or on Facebook, come across to twitch.tv/Irish? and join in. You can enter the raffles, and you can also enter the chat room and chat throughout the show like most of the people that are watching the show tonight are doing. If you would like to see some of the previous shows, just do a search for Irish Question Mark on YouTube, and it is very easy. In fact, what you could do is watch a previous show, record the answers, and then ask one of your friends and family to play against you for a crate of beer. It's an easy way to get a free crate of beer. If you have any ideas for next week's show, or if you would like any pictures put up, like Baronessa Burnham that sent a little picture earlier on, an absolute cracker. That'll be in next week's show. Or if you'd like to do what Johnny Rocket's done and send in a guest round, please remember, folks, you are not trying to embarrass people and make it so difficult it's heartbreaking. You just have to sort of go for something a bit more fun, and you can make it multiple choice, true or false, whatever you want. I will have a little play around with it and make sure it isn't too difficult. But email me directly at irishquestionmark@gmail.com or go via irishquestionmark.com and have a little look at the newly updated website. Okay, so here are your answers to the second half of the show. 1 point per correct answer, unless I tell you differently. Question number one, how many calories does a glass of water contain? The correct answer is 0 calories. It doesn't make a difference how big the glass is. And thanks for that, Pat the Beard. Question number two. Which country is the origin of the Stella beer? It is Belgium, of course. Stella Artois is what I was asking for. 1 point if you guessed that one right. Was the video from question one Gordy? You can't say that. You might take offense with that. Yeah. I don't think Gordy's that slim. Question number three. From which country is the this cheese from? It is, of course, from Switzerland. Jay Van Hastrick, thank you very much for your virtual tip, for your donation to the virtual tip jar. Thank you. Susie obviously agrees with me. She said she thought that too. Number four, what is the name of the gas that makes bread dough rise? For 1 point, the correct answer is carbon dioxide. My concern is when I see Gordy and Sue saying, I will cry myself to sleep tonight, is that Susan or is it Gordy? Number five, the Wife Carrying Festival. The major prize is the wife's weight in beer. Minion Jesse. Question number six, the French town that is known for its mustards is, of course, Dijon. Did you like the little French accent I put on there?
Wonderful.
Could you not have like said it in a more wonderful way? I'll cry myself to sleep as I have him lying next to me. Oh my God. Number seven. Holy Moses, it's bonus question time. What does that mean, her indoors? Meat sticks on the ticks. Sticks on the clicks. Fingers on the type. Holy moly. I like that one, Liz the Legend. Holy moly. It's bonus question time. Minion Jesse says at least there's no extra calories involved. Yeah, not too much water drank there. Okay, where are we? The last question was, okay. Yes. Now, folks, what can I tell you? Cobblers on the wobblers. I like that one, Captain Beer. Yeah. Piggies at the market. I honestly, I think David has the Radiant Veluca's other half. David, he has the keyboard. Keep going, David. Her indoors just said he's making me choke. Piggies at the market. Keep going. Okay, Baroness of Burnham said 1946. No. Stubs on the nubs. I like Piggies at the market too, just because it made her indoors nearly choke. Right, I'm moving on here, folks. So the chance to become winner number five out of a possible 6 places. Whee! All the way home. Here is your question. Now, I like this question, folks, which probably means you won't. There's a little bit of thinking required in this question. Remember, the first question... the first answer to get the correct answer, we'll call it out. Or if you're close enough before they all start coming in, i.e. people have looked up the answer. Liz said she doesn't do thinking. Electric Sheep Minion, I hate thinking. Yes, I'm sorry. This is why I said that I like this question, which probably means you won't. So here we go. Are you ready, folks? If you're ready, type yes in the chat or type your favorite tagline. Mike isn't ready. Mike, pour yourself a little drink and calm down. Okay, here we go. How many years elapsed between these two famous things that happened in history? How many years elapsed between the Wright brothers' first flight and Neil Armstrong's walk on the moon? How many years elapsed between the Wright brothers' first flight and Neil Armstrong's walk on the moon? Mike Bax, boom shakala, 66 years is the correct answer. Minion Micah was just behind. Well done. Winner number 5 in the spin the wheel is Mr. Mike Bax from Only Here for the Beer. Fantastic to have you here with us tonight, Mike. Okay, here we go. What is the name of the pan in which one makes paella? You want to give me another? Are you sure? Paella. Are you happy enough?
Yeah.
The correct answer is? What is the correct answer, Herndorf? You never listen to me. Paella is the actual answer because that's the name of the dish that they actually make paella in. Okay, enough Spanish. Number 8. Which vitamin is the only one that you will not find in an egg? 1.4, vitamin C. Number 9. What is the largest vegetable? Her indoors? A marrow. The correct answer is a pumpkin. Your marrow, the last time you seen a marrow. That's just called a fat courgette. Yeah, that's not called a marrow. And number 10. Dingbat Man! Solve this Dingbat for 5 points. A very well-known popular snack. It is mac and cheese. Mac and cheese for 5 points, folks. Now, Johnny B, our history guest round, and thank you very much, Radiant Reluca's David, for suggesting to Johnny to contact me and send in this. This is absolutely a great idea for anyone that wants to do a question round and you be the guest presenter. I mean, even I'm going to go as far to say is if you want to record yourself asking the questions, we'll even get you to ask them with me because your accent can't be as bad as mine. Number 1, the 1928 Olympic Games. What was the universal traffic sign that was first used at the event? Let's make this a double points round because it's a little bit tricky. 2 points if you guessed P, parking sign. So double points for the guest round. P, parking sign. Number 2. Name the year 1971, 1973 or 1975. The following 3 things happen. The introduction of the Big Mac Quarter Pounder. The birth of Starbucks. Or the release of Bowie's best, according to Johnny, Hunky Dory. The correct answer, 1971. 2 points if you guess that correct. Number 3, which English town links the following? The House Martins, Rotterdam, and the rank organization. Well, the answer is Hull. The House Martins are banned from Hull. Rotterdam Hull is the ferry, and the man that started the movie company, the rank organization, is a guy called Mr. Rank from Hull. Give yourself 2 points if you guess that right. No, the one that you've been waiting on. True or false? On the eve of Waterloo, 1815, the Duke of Wellington referred to his own troops when saying, "I don't know what effect they will have on the enemy, but by God, they scare the shit out of me." Is it true or is it false? Well, according to Johnny, it's true. So give yourself 2 points if you guessed that correct. Number four, five. In 1965, Kenneth Wallenstone described which footballer playing against Benfica. The clues were there. 1965, playing against Benfica. And here's best. This boy can really play. He's got another one because he scored a couple of goals in the final. Minion Jesse said it was either his troops or his feet. Yeah, yeah. Gordy, well done, Gordy. Number six, Ireland left the British Commonwealth in which year? The correct answer is 1949. That was after they joined the United Nations. Well done, Pat the Beard. Showing your age. Do you remember watching it live? Number seven, the Australian national carrier airline is Qantas. Formed in 1920, what does the acronym stand for? Queensland and Northern Territories Aerial Services is the answer that Johnny gave us. So give yourself 2 points if you guessed that correct. Number eight, what musical genre was Miles Davis referring to when he said, "I'll play it first and tell you what it is later"? The correct answer is jazz. 2 points for that. Number nine, Bob Dylan and George Bernard Shaw were the only two people that have been awarded which two special prizes? The Nobel Prize for Literature and an Oscar. So if you guessed either of them, give yourself a correct point. And if you guessed both of them, give yourself 2 points and a pat on the back, because it means that you've listened to previous shows. And number 10, true or false? All planets in our solar system rotate anti-clockwise. That is false, because Venus revolves clockwise. All the other planets revolve anti-clockwise, but on Venus, the day is longer than its year. Betty Gemini wanted to know what was the answer to number six. Let me have a little look. The answer was 1949. Thank you very much, Minion Jesse. You are on the ball. So, round six, our multiple guess round, and our last round tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Control your emotions. Boo! Question number one. What does the word piano mean? The correct answer is, for 1 point, A, to be played softly. Question number two. The War of the Roses involved which two houses in England? The correct answer is A, Lancaster and York. Three, there are up to 250,000 sweat glands in which part of the body? The correct answer is B, the feet. Our son, you mean? Junior. Number four, in the ancient Roma, which mineral was considered so valuable that soldiers were partially paid for it? The correct answer is B, salt. Number five, Jan the Man. Which football club won the UEFA League 2019-2020? It was B, Bayern Munich. Number six, the veggie that was originally used to make jack-o'-lanterns in Scotland and Ireland during Halloween, that was C, turnips. Number seven, where did the boomerang get its name? The correct answer, it was answer C, the name of a native tribe in Australia. Yes, Gordy, we will accept neeps as well. Basically, it's a Scottish name for turnips because they can't spell turnip. Number eight. Pat the Beard said, Boomerangagang, to be precise. Boomerangang. Oh, I get it now. Boomerangang. Nice one, Pat the Beard. Remind me to slap you the next time I get you. Boomerangagang. Which of the following objects in your household contains the most germs? A, a cell phone, B, a kitchen sponge, or C, a light switch? The correct answer is B, a kitchen sponge. Oh, it's bonus question time, folks, for the last time. What are our taglines here indoors?
Meat sticks on the ticks.
Ticks on the clicks.
Piggies at the market.
Holy moly. Yikes. Anything else? I'm sure Jan the Man had a classic one. Choppers on the blocks. Boom. Floppers on the chop. Cloppers. Okay. I think we'll have to organize a poll for your people to vote which one they want used. We can't keep using every one of them. Fingers on the tape. That's the one. Thanks, Jan the Man. Fingers on the tape. Yeah, I know. He just does it out of sympathy because he wants you to feel important here indoors. Tips on the nips. Tips on the nips. Betty Gemini wants them all. I bet you do. Okay, here we go, folks. So this is your last chance to get your name on the Spin the Wheel, which we're going to do straight after the after we finish this show. Okay, here we go. Are you ready, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and anyone that is gender neutral? Here is your question for your last chance to get on our Spin the Wheel. And the Spin the Wheel tonight, the prizes are, we have our mystery prize, or we have, if you're living local, the chance to get some to come to the house and pick up some Irish question mark handmade soda farls. And anyone that has tried them so far, Radiant Raluca, who else has had them? Captain Beer, Minion Jesse, Pete and Rachel, they only had a couple of them. Who else? Micah, Minion, of course. Okay, Flickers on the Clickers. Thanks, Matt. Mike, Flickers on the Clickers. Here we go. Here is the question. It's a numbers answer. How many stories did each of the World Trade Towers have? Obviously, before they fell down. So what was the number of floors on the World Trade Towers in New York City? Get your numbers in the chat. The first correct answer we see gets the answer. Captain, is he already in it? Captain Beer, Robert, gets the correct answer, 110 stories. First one in. Was he not already on the Spin the Wheel? No. Okay. Well done, Captain Beer. Space Dracula, 112, very close, but not right. Lizzie said he just knew it. Yeah, absolutely. Well done. Okay, so what will we do? Let's move swiftly along and give you the last couple of answers. What was the original name of the Rubik's Cube when it was invented in Hungary in 1974 by Erno Rubik? The answer was A, Magic Cube. And number 10, our last visit from the Dingbat Man. Solve this, Dingbat, for 5 points for a well-known four-word term or phrase. to infinity and beyond is the correct answer. To infinity and beyond. Remember, the anagrams and the dingbats are worth 5 points. Dingbat! Dingbat! Alrighty. Folks, thank you very much indeed for anyone that has sent in a virtual tip donation to the virtual tip jar. I've just dropped the links for the last time. If you'd like to send a little donation, thank you very much for anyone that has sent in a donation so far. Greatly appreciated. Okay, I think it's time to spin the wheel. Yes, indeed. We're going to tell you who's who. Call it out. Winner number one on Spin the Wheel is Jan the Man. Winner number two is Minion Jesse. Winner number three, Minion Rachel. Winner number four, Dublin Pete on Holidays in Carrick and Shannon. Winner number five, Mike Bax from Only Here for the Beer. And winner number six, also from Only Here for the Beer, Captain Beer. Alrighty, let's see if we can smoothly move. Let's keep it going. Just keep things calm here. Keep things calm. Okay, folks, here we go. Is this going to work or is this not going to work? Let's see. Her indoors, what do I need to do?
Spin the wheel.
Louder, her indoors, what do I need to do?
Spin the wheel.
Boom. The wheel is spinning. The winner is winner number one, has won a mystery prize.
Jan the Man.
Jan the Man, our Dutch referee. You have the choice, Jan the Man, for one of the Irish Question Mark mystery prizes, or to come along, sit outside, grab a coffee with me, and I'll make you some very special Irish soda farls, which can be eaten at breakfast time, lunchtime, evening time, or even in the middle of the night. Congratulations and well done. Thank you very much indeed. Okay, moving swiftly back to... we've got to do our draw. Oh, the excitement's killing me. Last chance, folks. Type George into the chat. Last chance. Type George into the chat. Radiant Verluca had the pleasure of trying the Irish Question Mark soda farls a couple of times. Her and David absolutely loved it. Okay. Last chance, folks, to type George in the chat. If you have not already, you could possibly have your face on these pictures next week, being one of our limited edition prize winners. Our mystery prize winners club. Alrighty. You can let me know after the show's finished, or drop me a phone call or an email, Jan the Man, whether you want the bread or the mystery prize. Okay, shall we do the draw, her indoors?
Yeah.
Is it going to work?
Of course it is.
Calm yourself down. I nearly spun the wheel again. Now, that really would have caused problems. Okay, right. Let me have a look, just a quick look to make sure that... everyone's names are in there, up there. Yes. Rexy Minion. Yes. Mike, Micah, Rachel. Yeah. Pete, SRB, Pat the Beard, everybody. Okay. Here we go. Give us a little drum roll, her indoors. Congratulations. The winner is... Grab 88. And Space Dracula, you were in the draw. Yes, I only read out a few random ones. Maracas. Grab Idiot is still with us. Fantastic. Okay, so it is really easy. Grab Idiot, you have the choice of one of the mystery prizes, or you can, because you're local, you can come and get some Irish question mark special soda farls. So all you need to do is contact me via the irishquestionmark@gmail.com. And if you're a winner tonight, who are our winners tonight? Grab Idiot and
Jan the Man.
Email me via irishquestionmark@gmail.com and let me know what you'd like. If you want one of the mystery prizes, we can. If you're local and you want to pop around and pick it up, that's fantastic. Grab Idiot, I think, is based out in Delft, are they? I'm not sure. I can't remember. Yes, Delft, I think. No, I don't know. Anyway, Grab Idiot, where are you based? I'm talking like you're not even here. Let us know. And if you want to pop in and pick something up, if not, I can post off the mystery prize to you. Okay, folks, thank you very much. Special mention to Christopher and Armagh, who always watches the show either live on Facebook or on YouTube rerun. Grab Idiot, she wants to know about the mystery. Well, you listen to yours indoors. I can either post it to you or you can come on the bicycle and pick it up at my house. Let me know either way by email. Folks, thank you very much indeed. Special thank you to Johnny Rockets for the guest history round. Anyone else would like to send in a guest round, you can record yourself asking the questions. We can do anything you want to do, but remember, it's a family show and don't make it too hard. Special thank you to the members of the Only Here for the Beer joining us tonight, all of you. It's been a hard week, and may Gunther rest in peace. Thank you very much. Folks, it has been an absolute pleasure once again to share our Friday nights. Would you like to put your scores in the chat? I can call a few scores out randomly. Baroness of Burnham, 58. Congratulations. Gordy said, I was in the toilet for a week afterwards. Grab Idiot, buyer beware. Thanks for that, Gordy. Rachel, thank you very much for your donation to the virtual tip jar. Thank you very much. And 36 points. Well, you just need to get more people involved. 69 points for the Minions. I don't care whether that was their score or not, but I like the way they're thinking. 49, Norma. Thanks. Thank you very much, Norma, and her indoors. Thank you very much, of course. Norma, I'm glad that that was your favorite song. Anyone would like me to sing a certain song, send it in to me. If it's not too difficult, I'll give it a bash. Gordian Sue's 73. Mike Batts, 76. Well done, Mike. I thought you'd be up there. Folks, what can I tell you? It has been an absolute pleasure. I'll see you all next Friday. Spread the word, folks, so we can get more people involved in our weekly quiz show. Her Indoors, thank you very much indeed. I missed a happy birthday. Frank didn't get the chance to wish him a birthday. Obviously, the naked netball was a lot more exciting than the quiz show. Mm-hmm. Folks, whatever you do, stay the Frank at home.
Caught a virus, you're not in this alone, but you can help to cure it, just stay the fuck at home.
We're all stuck here in quarantine, it's like the Twilight Zone. To save the world, you only have to stay the fuck at home.
Stay the fuck at home, stay the fuck at home.
Don't you be a fucking dick,
stay the fuck at home.
Netflix in your underwear.
Just stay the fuck at home.
But I need the gym and I need the beach. We hear you bitch and moan. You need to grow a brain cell and stay the fuck at home.
But I feel fine, I don't feel sick, I'll go out on my own. I think of you, you selfish prick, just stay the fuck at home.
Stay the fuck at home. Stay the fuck at home.
Sit on the couch and do fuck all.
Just stay the fuck at home.
Faster than a hooker's legs, so stay the fuck at home.
To the doctors and the truckies, those who put food on our plate, you keep the whole place running so we can isolate.
Stay the fuck at home. Stay the fuck at home.
You can be a hero too.
Stay the fuck at home.
The only way to slow it down is isolate, not roam. Help the world get on track and stay the fuck at home.
Sit on the couch and drink VV, get shit-faced on your own. We don't care what you're doing there, just stay the fuck at home.
Contact family, use Facebook, Skype or phone. Yeah, we've got the fucking internet, so stay the fuck at home.
From LA through to Berlin, from Wuhan through to Rome, there's people dying every day. Please stay the fuck at home.
Stay the fuck at home. Stay the fuck at home.
Don't you be a fucking dick.
Stay the fuck at home. Stay the fuck at home.
You be a fucking dick.
Stay the fuck at home.
Stay the fuck at home.
Alrighty, folks. Thank you very much indeed. Take care. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. I'll see you next Friday. Stay the fuck.